Hey YouTube, Ben Marouski here with another really quick product review. Today I'm going to be talking about this Piersberg vacuum pump for your Mini Cooper S N14 engine equipped cars. So that's Cooper S's from 2007 until 2010 and JCW's from 2009 to 2012. So what I'm going to talk about specifically is how this vacuum pump failing can cause an extreme amount of carnage to your N14 engine. So the vacuum pump's job is actually pretty straightforward. It powers your brake booster and also your auxiliary solenoids. It's cam driven, so it rides right off of your exhaust camshaft. The vacuum pump is also lubricated by oil. So there's an oil passage in the head of your N14 engine that basically lubricates the vacuum pump, and that's sort of where the failure of these pumps tends to happen. Essentially, that passage can get blocked either with debris or oil starvation just from not doing enough oil changes. Various things can basically cause it to clog up, and when this fails, catastrophe happens. So we're going to end up taking a little bit of a closer look as to how that series of events happens, because it happens extremely quickly. Now, there are things you can do to simply prevent this from happening. The vacuum pump sits right here on the side of your head with three 10 millimeter bolts. It's extremely simple to, you know, just get in there and remove it, almost like you would for any sort of routine maintenance. You take those three bolts off, you pop the vacuum pump off, and there's a few things that I'm going to show you that you can kind of do to test it, just to see if it seems like it's up to normal working conditions or if it might be on its way out. So in front of me, we have three of the same exact vacuum pumps, just at three different points of their life. So we have the brand new Piersberg vacuum pump, which we're about to put on my car. We have one with 120,000 miles on it that's working but has simply seen better days. And then a previous one of mine that had 40,000 miles on it and basically caused a catastrophic failure. We're going to take a quick look at as to how to diagnose whether or not these would be working if they're on your car and kind of how to go from there. So we'll start by looking at the brand new one, which would work 100% the way it's supposed to. So I'm going to remove this real quick. And what you would do when inspecting is simply you check the O-ring. Obviously this one is brand new, so it would have a perfectly fine seal. And then I'm just going to do a little bit of a test by just spinning it. Now this seems super obvious, but if you pick this up and it doesn't spin and you can feel no back pressure, so when you do spin it, you'll feel like a little bit of resistance and then it'll almost give. And a little bit of resistance and then it'll give. That's this just building vacuum with your hand. So this is what your camshaft is doing, just a way lot, or a way faster and way more often. But if we look at one that is failed, which is this one, this is me trying to spin it. So it's completely locked, and so you can think that's probably not what your cam wants to do. It wants to turn. We think that this one actually failed because the shop that had originally worked on this, you can see there's a ton of RTV here, and there's a tiny, tiny hole that is where the lubrication of oil comes from. And if that gets clogged, this essentially seizes up. So we'll also open this up and we'll kind of show you guys inside, and you can see where all the scoring is from when this vacuum pump actually failed. This is what your vacuum pump would probably look like if you took it off of your Mini Cooper with, say, 50,000 plus miles on it. Yes, it's seen prettier, better days. You can see a little bit of oil had leaked out of this at some point. It could just be some curmudgeon. But the seal, looking at it, looks okay. I would still replace it now that it's off of the vehicle. But you can see here, turning it, it also still turns similarly to the new one. No weird noises, no weird buildup or resistance. There is a little bit of wiggle no matter what, new or used. If it's any more than this, then it might be alarming, but you can see it's sort of slotted here. So it does make sense that there's a little bit of play. Also, these will make a ticking sound. Don't be alarmed by that. That does not mean your vacuum pump is failing. It's super normal. Originally, when these first came out, people were complaining and they thought that it was an actual failed vacuum pump, but expect a little bit of noise coming from this pump at idle. All right, so we're gonna take a quick look at a Mini N14 head and how your vacuum pump actually sits on the head and how it is sort of married up to your camshaft. So looking at the camshaft here, you can see it's almost like a key slot. And here's your key, your vacuum pump. So really, they just slide into each other and lock in accordingly. So your vacuum pump slots into your camshaft here. And then on the other end of your exhaust cam is this exhaust cam sprocket. So this is held in by a torque to yield bolt. What that means is when you torque it, it essentially stretches into place and it's a one-time use only bolt. Now this is where your catastrophic failure happens. So when this vacuum pump fails due to likely oil starvation, it locks up completely. So if you have your camshaft running, constantly trying to spin, your vacuum pump doesn't want to spin, what happens is the bolt that actually holds this sprocket in place snaps in half. So you can see here inside the exhaust cam, you can see half of a bolt in there because we haven't removed it yet. And this is the head of that bolt that simply sheared off completely. Now, what happens from there is even worse. This sprocket falls down, your timing chain falls down, and everything is basically found in the bottom of your block, where this sprocket, which controls your entire timing chain running off of the crankshaft, basically eats itself. So it's sort of a series of events that leads from one thing to another, and it all sort of stems from this vacuum pump failing. From that, your engine slips time, and we'll look underneath this head and you can see what happens there. Pretty obviously, the valves kiss the pistons, and yeah, so you have basically a full rebuild. So in conclusion, hopefully you found this product review helpful. The intention was never to scare you any more than we already have on your N14 mini engines. But if you did like this video, please hit that like button below. If you have any questions about N14s or minis, feel free to put them in the comment section below. And as always, please hit subscribe if you're not already.